Highness. Your Highness, I didn't kill her. I didn't know what happened.
What do you mean you don't know what happened? You just told us how you saw yourself on top of the girl. What were you doing on top of a fellow girl like you in the first place? Are you possessed?
Believe me, my father, your Highness, believe me, I did not kill her. I didn't kill her.
Gods!
Yes, Your Majesty.
Yes, Your Majesty.
Take her. She's evil. She's a killer. Move, move, move.
Can you imagine this girl? This girl is an evil girl.
Your Highness, you sent for me.
Yes, I did. I want you to gather all the maidens in this palace for a short recess. The ambulance will soon arrive to take the body of the dead girl to the mortuary.
It will be done at once, Your Highness.
Just imagine. Can't you imagine that? She's possessed. It's an evil girl.
From the pit of hell, I condemn you. I curse you. Because the Bible tells me, any tongue that rises up against me in judgment shall be condemned. Therefore, I condemn and curse you with the precious blood of Jesus. I condemn you to go back to Abyss where you're coming from. By the precious blood of our Lord Jesus Christ that I was ransomed, I declare that it is well with me. I declare that I shall not remain on this bed. I declare that I will get up from this bed to the glory of God. I declare that it is to the glory of God that I'm well. In Jesus' name I have prayed.
Amen.
Your Highness, the Honorable of Ashley Kingdom, what up, prayer? May you live long. Elders and chiefs, I greet you all.
Chief Priest, the royal chiefs of Acheuli Kingdom summoned me here to listen to what you have to say about this kingdom. Go on.
I am the eye of my eyes. The Ogewe of my eyes. Wohai. Tamame. Excuse me. Your Highness, the entire kingdom of Echili is under siege. The royal house is in bondage of evil forces. Excuse me, all over. I speak the truth as I reveal everything before the eyes of Echili Kingdom.
What is happening to the chief priest?
Your Highness, we are survivors, you are. Well.
Oh, my
God!
Brother chiefs of Acheuli Kingdom, you summoned me here to listen to what the chief priest has to say about this kingdom. As it is, what just transpired is highly embarrassing. I will take my leave for now, because I'm very tired, and I won't be in the position next time to witness such nonsense. Excuse me.
Why are you looking upset and ruffled?
Is it not the king's friend, no sir? I went to serve him food
and he tried to roll me to his bed.
What did you do?
Me. I pushed him down and ran out of the room.
Go back in there and give the man what he asks of you.
Edward, what is your case? State it.
Your Highness, 2 months ago, my uncle here offered me 5 million to sell my land to him, which I refused. Recently, he sent us and they beat me up. Look at the evidence of their beatings.
Your Highness, what my nephew said is not true. First of all, the land in question was given to me by my late brother, Itua's father. He said that I should use the land to train him in school, but he refused to go to school. There's nothing I can do. My son, Gabriel, offered him 10 million naira and not 5 million naira.
For the land?
Yes, for that piece of land. He wants to use it to build a filling station for this community. He brought the story of Bruin and the Todri. I don't know.
Uncle, you are lying, no? You are lying. Say the truth. You are lying, no?
That's why you are a fool. You are a very big fool. Your father wanted the best for you, and that's why he instructed your uncle here to ensure your success. But because of your stupidity, he refused. He refused. Look at you. Even a 10 million naira offer to you was not good enough for you. Save your life. If you don't want to better your life, give chance to someone who wants to do a developmental project in this community. My elders, is it not development we need in this community?
Eriola, it's development we need.
Good. Owadia, when is your son coming back to build the filling station in question?
Yes, it will, in 2 weeks' time, my son will be here.
Your Highness, I can't sell my only possession of land to my cousin just because he has money. I cannot.
Etwa, are you in any way questioning my authority? Hmm? Anyways, that aside. Chiefs of Achili Kingdom,
your Highness,
the piece of land in question
That land will be given to Wabed's son to build the ferry station for this community. It is our development project that this community needs. As it is, my chiefs, elders of Achille Kingdom.
Your Highness.
That's my final judgment.
That's right. We need development.
What? Yes, Emma. I'm afraid. Danger is looming in this kingdom.
I agree with you. I perfectly agree with you. Our king has lost it. It's as if we don't even have a king.
Oh. That would have been better than
having a king who passes arbitrary judgment and stays out with strangers in the palace. Can you imagine? Our king's palace, a sacred place, now home to strangers? I don't even know if those his friends are not sleeping with some of the maidens in the palace.
Osanugura, may the land forbid bad thing. What are you saying? What are you even saying? May my eyes not see my ears. Look, no matter how arrogant or irrational the king may have become, he dare not try such a taboo to happen in this kingdom. If not, it will spell doom for this kingdom.
You are. Look, now you're getting what I am saying. With what I have witnessed so far with the king, my assertion is not far-fetched. Anything can happen. I am still wondering what happened to Ebili. Since almost a week now, he's still not talking.
That is a part of the danger I was talking about. Strange things are happening. If not, how could Ebili, who was supposed to have given us all we need, gone dumb? That's it.
There is another task you must carry out in due course.
Say it, my queen, and it shall be done.
Go and have your bath. Prepare, for tonight is a night of consummation.
Yes, my queen.
My son, whom I told you that would be here in 2 weeks' time, was kidnapped on his way back from Port Harcourt. Yeah. I am confused, Your Highness.
Owadia,
What are you expecting me to do in a situation like this?
I wouldn't like my son to die. That is why I'm here. Your Highness, help me out from this matter.
Your son will not die. It's a case of kidnap. Kidnappers don't kill their victims, except on stubborn grounds. What they do is that they demand for ransom. So it is in your shoes now to gather what they've requested and give it to them. And then your son will be alive.
No, what that money is too much for me, Your Highness. It's too much for me. I need your help.
The fact remains that I'm the king of this kingdom, but it does not mean I have to take over the duties of the police. If I do, what would the police do?
For me, that is why I'm here. I want you to help me out from this matter.
You remember you told me your son deals in the oil industry?
Yes.
Obviously, he has colleagues, he has friends. So you go and meet them, let them gather money for these kidnappers, and you take it to them. Because sometimes kidnappers are very dangerous. In order for you not to lose your son, you have to be very fast about it. Huh?
Thank you, Your Highness.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Good morning, Your Majesty.
Good morning, Doctor.
Good morning, Doctor.
Morning, my daughter. How are you?
I'm fine, Doctor.
Your Majesty, how are you this morning?
Doctor, I think I want to go home.
Ah, good. Let's see. All right, Your Majesty. But how can you cope without a wheelchair? You cannot live here without their wheelchair.
Okay, Doctor. Get the wheelchair.
All right, Your Majesty. Let me now go and start making preparations for this church. But I need to inform His Highness.
No, no. Just arrange a car for me.
Oh, Your Majesty. That shall be done. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Doctor.
Mother, why didn't you inform me that you were coming back home?
I guess you found out because I summoned the maids and the guards, right?
Obviously.
Pastor Zé, how have you been coping with your duties? I heard that a maiden was killed and another arrested. How have you been able to resolve the issue as the king?
Well, how else do you want me to resolve the issue? A maiden killed another maiden in her sleep. She had to go in for it.
That's not all, Osaze. Because I am not yet convinced that Ese could hurt a fly. Talk less of taking a human life. There is something very strange going on in this palace, and I intend to get to the root of it all.
Mother, why would you want to stress yourself over forgotten issues? Especially in this present condition of yours.
Asaze, please leave my room.
The Queen Mother has returned from the hospital, so we decided to come and see her.
It's unfortunate. I'm afraid you cannot see the Queen.
Your Highness, is there any problem?
No, not at all. But you cannot just see the Queen.
In that case, we should go and inform the other chiefs. Not about that coming.
Please do.
Long day.
Why are you being unnecessarily emotional over nothing?
Tonight, let me remind you of the periodic sacrifices of a newborn baby. I am here to represent the goddess of the sea. Always remember that the goddess of the sea will show no mercy if you don't do what she asks you to do. Time is ticking! Time is ticking! The goddess! You know the penalty if you don't bring the newborn baby!
Yes, my queen. Is there anything you demand of me?
My husband, send them away. Send the royal guards away. The secret of the palace will be best preserved without the prying eyes of the royal guards. My husband, send them away. Send the royal guards away. Because the palace needs its privacy.
I like this. Come here for me. This one?
Yes, Your Majesty.
I have noticed that since I came back from the hospital, the guards have not been around. What happened?
Your Majesty, His Highness laid them off.
What? Laid them off? Why? Ha! Sanubualabo. What is wrong with this boy? Must he be changing everything at will? Adesua, please go and tell him that I seek his attention.
Yes, Your Majesty.
Thank you. No, no, let me move for you. Okay. What is the joy for me when at this stage of my life, I don't even have a daughter anymore? Not to talk of having a grandchild.
Mother. Must you always bring up this issue whenever we're having a very decent conversation?
Of course. I have to bring it in because it is very vital. I mean, you succeeded your father a long time ago. And up till now, you don't even have a queen. A kingdom without a queen. How shameful.
But I have a queen.
Really? Why haven't you shown her to me all this while? Huh? Where is she?
You, mother.
Excuse me?
Yes, mother. You are the queen mother of this kingdom, aren't you?
Osaze, you're not serious. You are just not serious. You think everything is a joke, right? Why are you behaving as if you don't know what I'm talking about? I am not your queen. And I will never be your queen. I am your mother. As in your mother.
Mother, mother. Must you always get upset and start shouting whenever we're having a conversation?
Asaze, if you are not comfortable with my shouting and my getting upset, then you have to listen to me. Get yourself a wife. As a king, you need a wife. You cannot operate without a wife. Get yourself a wife, Osaze. This is time for you to face reality. You need a wife. Get yourself a wife. Ah.